Hello, 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 guys and girls. Welcome back to my Spyro 3 walkthrough. We are now starting a rather fun level, I must say, Sunny Villa. Now, it's quite important that you have done Sheila's out before this, because otherwise you won't be able to do the Sheila, what's it called, challenge that has been this level. Anywho, this is quite a good fun level, I must say. Basic stuff. Nice sort of Roman setting. I guess meant to be ancient Rome.
Oh my, can you help us? Hordes of ferocious Rhynocs have overrun our town and kidnapped the mayor.
Nice headgear there, I must say. I mean, it does amaze me how the Rhynocs can overrun this town, because if you go near them, they don't even try and shoot you or anything, they just cower in front of you. And yet they've kidnapped the mayor. Although,
let me catch my breath and I'll kick that other guy's butt.
You'll soon see that tourist isn't that hard to overrun them, because they do nothing. They just stand there playing with their tails like, oh, it's so much fun.
Show those two bullies. If they hadn't outnumbered me 2-1, I'd have finished them off ages ago.
Oh, 2-1. Well, guess what, mate? It's Spyro against the world here. Honestly, you can do better than that. There are some giant monsters up there that did look quite intimidating, but honestly, you think those Roman bears, wherever they are, would be able to defend themselves properly. And I'm a little short guy as well, so it's not about height, isn't it? Oh, it's important that you get all those green plant things, because you get a skill point for getting them all. Who find them all, I mean. Oh, and Zoe's here to give us more hints. Good old Zoe.
You'll have to flame him using the circle button.
I can never get this right. Is this a club or is that a chicken leg? Either way, it's going to hurt us, I'm pretty sure, so just flame it. Actually, that's making me hungry, thinking of roasting some chicken under Spyro's breath. Chicken legs. Being a student, I can't afford luxuries like KFC that you can usually afford. On his neck, just lying around. Honestly, you sort of feel like they put them somewhere tactical, but instead they just put the egg there and think, yeah, Spyro won't find that. He's only a dragon who's killed two dictators, saved thousands of characters from death and destruction, you know. It's almost like they were challenging us. Spyro himself, if Spyro would talk out loud, he'd be like, oh, come on, this is too easy. Anyway, in terms of how I'm going to do this level, I will get the main level done first, and then I shall attempt the awesome side challenges, such as this one down here, which is Sheila's one. What does her sign say? Come on in! Come on down! Before you've rescued the characters, because typically there are some challenges that you can't access when you haven't got when you haven't bought the characters. For example, in Molten Crater, a level in this world, there's a Sergeant Bird challenge, which you can't normally access because you haven't been able to free him yet. I say normally, you'll see what I mean later on in the walkthrough. And then the Sorceress will leave you a little note. What I mean to say is, I've never seen the Sorceress's note for Sheila, because I've never been in that situation where I haven't bought Sheila first. It sort of makes sense, to be honest. She's the last thing to do in Sunrise Spring Home, as it were. Oh, that was perfectly timed. Miles. I'd go 500 miles. I'd go 500 more just to be the dragon who walks 1,000 miles to get 150 eggs. So I was trying to make some sort of clever rhyme there. Didn't work out too well. But hey! Back this way now. I think Zoe's going to be here for more banter.
Hi, Spyro.
Each time a fairy zaps you,
that means your
she saves your progress. I'd love to see, like, Zoe trying to explain to Spyro that it saves the game player's memory card. It's quite being like, what? I'm a game? My whole life is just a game? A story for someone else to enjoy? And they'd just be like, Zoe would be like, we're getting too philosophical here. And there's a giant chicken. That looked a bit nerve-wracking. I wouldn't want to be that giant chicken. Because I think it's sort of implied that he gets his chicken. Is that an everyday phrase? Go out and win the chicken. I'll just hurt the bear.
Ooh, I'm dizzy.
So considering we're so small, I don't understand how the Rhynoc would be scared of us and not be scared of a guy wearing a toga. He just stands there like, yeah, the dragon will take care of things.
Thanks for the help, but I think I would have worn him down in a minute.
Yeah, I'm sure. That's an interesting tactic. I'll keep running away from him. Eventually, he'll get tired. And that's the only guy who seems to be in charge of kidnapping the mayor.
Thank you for rescuing my town. As mayor,
there we go.
I award you with one of our famous giant chicken eggs.
Smells like the biggest eggs I've ever seen, but here we go. Another little dragon egg for us. Who can dance? Brilliant. Wish I could do that when I came out of my mum's womb.
I'm sorry. That was the ugliest chicken I've ever seen.
That's because it was a dragon. I wonder for... I feel sorry for the people of this area. They're clearly not that bright, are they? I'm going to leave it, aren't I? And then one of just overrun again. I can tell. Hopefully I've got all the plants now. Cracking.
Hi, Spyro. I found this gladiator training arena, and it makes a pretty cool skate park. Care for a test of your boarding skills?
Oh yeah, I was the reason why they started doing
can't
tests.
Catch all 15 of the lizards running around here.
Oh really? We're sincere about that. It's quite funny though. It's a gladiator training arena with loads of launch ramps and half pipes. I mean, what sort of gladiators are there at Sunny Villa? Honestly, but it is a brilliant side quest though. I love Spyro's skateboarding challenges. I thought this was a pretty good skate park as well, until I saw the one in Enchanted Towers. If you haven't seen that one yet, you will love it, believe me. Your jaw will drop like a good piece of dubstep. Tony Hawk would be drooling if he saw it. Just a quick note though, for those of you who are new to Spyro 3, there's always the main level, and then there's always a couple of side quests to do in each level, like at least two usually, and Spyro can try like new skills like skateboarding and all sorts, driving vehicles. So jealous actually. I mean, he's meant to be here saving the dragon eggs, and he's doing crazy things like skateboarding. There's one thing that's missing though. I wish Spyro had a pair of awesome trousers like Hunter does. I mean, Hunter is a great character and all, but he does nothing in each level, to be honest. He just turns up and gets all the credit. Damn it, that was meant to end a little bit differently to how I planned it. I'm just getting the gems as well as getting visits as well, because there's quite a few gems in here. That sort of worked. Flip's sake. As you can tell, I'm what? I don't know, I'd say I'm okay at skateboarding. I enjoy it though, at least. Although I'm very picky with like getting a record. If I go for the course record, which you can after you've done the main task, I'm all like, okay, I've got to get each move perfect. If I fail a move, I'll restart the challenge again. I won't be able to do it this time because I'm sort of constricted by time here. I'll have to post a video of like my best record of the track, as it were, at a later date. Seriously though, Spyro is the real hero and he gets no perks like trousers or anything. Whereas Hunter's here, he's like, hey Spyro, nice one with saving the mayor and all. I've been waiting for you, but I've got these sweet trousers just for doing sweet FA. I mean, it's not much asking for a pair of trousers, but it's the little things in life that make it worthwhile. I'll just get the rest of the gems by foot, to be honest. It's slower, but it's a lot easier. Annoyingly, though, the lizards just jump into their holes and just, which randomly appear. It's like, oh, this ground was ground originally, but now it's a hole, so have that, Spyro. And yes, these are the lizards that appeared in Glimmer. No idea why they're here in Sunny Villa as well. Loads of things that were in the last game making a cameo appearance, as it were, here. Which is quite nice, actually. I like that. I think I've got most of the gems, though. Although it's an odd number, which for some reason I find to be a bad thing. If it's an odd number, I don't know. Usually the even numbers mean you've got enough gems, but we shall have to wait and see. I'm not that bad skateboarding that I can't turn my board, it's just my analog stick. I know it sounds like I'm making excuses, but when I get in the zone, I can really bust out some moves. See, there you go, that's a spin and a half, isn't it? I remember, like, this game actually encouraged me to go out and try skateboarding. I instantly assumed I'd better go up a half pipe and do a quick turn, just like Spyro learned so quickly. How wrong I was. I think I missed a gem there, did I? That's what we're talking about. That's some skills there. And that one's up there, and that sort of worked. That's not bad either. That's what's called a twisted lemon. I think the hardest move to do is a nasty knock. I can never get that move. I'll try and enchant towers where there's we can get more air and... But you'll see what I mean later on.
Hey, that was great! And while you were boarding, I found this in a lizard burrow.
Oh really? Just by complete chance? Like, oh, I'm gonna go up to the lizard's burrow and there goes an egg. Whereas I just killed 15 lizards.
If you can catch all the lizards without wiping out, and before time runs out, I might be able to scrounge up another egg. It's not...
That's a little bit naughty, I think, to be honest.
Get him, Spyro.
He's like, I might be able to find you an egg, which sounds like he has found Spyro an egg. But he won't just give it to him, no, he's got to make him do a challenge. I suppose he's, in a friendly way, he's pushing Spyro, you know, to like, to work for his egg, as it were. But even so, if he was a true friend, he'd just give me the egg. Or Spyro would just flame his butt. Spyro should just flame his... cat behind thing. I don't know where I was going with that. I almost said something and I thought that could be a bit dodgy. Anyway, you've got more than enough time for this. I would say 2 minutes would be much... 2 minutes would be much more of a challenge, to be honest. If you're new to the skateboarding, you're much more likely to, wipe out then run out of time, believe me. I'm not sure how it works out mathematically in terms of how many you've got to get like per minute or second rather. But as you can see, like I'm halfway and I've not even gone through my first minute yet. That's how much time you have. Gets one here as well on the way down. That's what I'm talking about. Be careful here. Why would you make a lovely corridor and then put these random poles in the middle of it? It makes no sense! Oh, where's the last one? It's at the top, isn't it, I think? Oh, it's gonna be close. Oh, that was very close indeed. Cowabunga.
Whoa, that was sweet! And look! There was another egg in the lizard burrow.
What a great surprise. Lucky that he had found one, because otherwise I would have been quite annoyed that he promised me an egg and he's like, actually, Spyro, I couldn't find one.
You can go for the course record now if you want. Whenever you...
So basically, now you've got to use tricks which you use... You do rather using the triangle button. So you can do twisted lines like that. If you've really got enough air, you can use... I swear that was four spins. That was a gulp. And that was... That might have been a twisted lime or something or other. Damn it. Damn it. No, no. I'll keep with what I've got. The highest score you've got to beat is 3,500. Yeah, but if you can get some real air off this big ramp here at the top, you can usually... what's it called? Like, get three flips or backflips or rolls. Rolls where you go left to right. When you press triangle. This is meant to build up speed, so hopefully I should be able to get three flips in. No, I won't. That wasn't just a backflip. That was at least a twisted lemon or twisted lime. I'll have a cheek of it. I guess I should stick to what I know, I suppose. Need to make sure that I actually get 3,500 as well, not just showing off where I think I can show off anyway. Damn it! That was pushing it a little bit. That's more like it. Now that's what I call a twisted lemon. I haven't seen many twisted lemons in my time, but that was pretty twisted. A couple of knots in there at least. And there we go. As I said, I'll come back later on and I'll post a video showing my best attempt. You can get some really good scores on this park, even though it's quite... It's a good park. Not as good compared to like the later one in Enchanted Towers, but you can still get a pretty good score from it. Like, I've seen people who get 5 figures in this task. But that's for another time. I'll just quickly make sure that there's no more gems in here. I'm paranoid now, after having got all but one in the last in the home world. It's like a bad omen for this walkthrough. I'm gonna I'll lose a gem in each level. Slightly worrying, but hopefully it won't be that bad. And out we go. Typically, all the plants are now growing back. The cheek of it, going back in front of Spyro. I'd be too scared to go back up. Like, you know what? I'm not gonna go back. And there's a giant chicken just appear from nowhere. In Spyro 3, even the chickens can apparate. Don't know why he or she could be a female chicken randomly appears there. But yeah, it's a nice touch. Make me hungry again now, thinking about roast chicken and grilled chicken. Deep fried chicken. Anyway, on to Sheila's level. Thankfully, kangaroo hasn't got the same effect on the mind as food usually does. Anyway.
Hey Spyro, there are Rhynocs everywhere. Maybe we can find some peace and quiet at the top of the tower.
It's funny that, isn't it? Area's under siege and yet there's Rhynocs everywhere. What do you know?
Alas, I have lost them.
And the voice is going crazy. Great.
Rhynocs at the top of yonder tower.
Slight speech impediment. Which I can associate myself with a little bit, but you know. Here we go. More fun with Sheila. Usually there's quite a few gems in here, but this is a very big jumping one. In terms of Sheila anyway. Like this is the only challenge that really utilizes her jumping ability, I would say, out of all the challenges that Sheila has in the game. The other ones sort of utilize her ability to stomp things. Which is a shame, because I like the jumping missions. I suppose that you can only do one thing with the stomping. Sorry, with the jumping missions, really. But I still like it. These guys aren't half annoying, though. See, these are proper strong Rhynocs. Why aren't those in the main area? I could certainly see them taking care of the mayor, but not the ones that are actually in the main area. Anyway. More fun with the game's only Australian character. Put a shrimp on the barbie, mate. Let's watch some Neighbours. Don't worry, I'm sorry if that sounds stereotypical at me. So that means that if this video gets any dislikes, it's probably going to be an Australian person. Crystal Fisher, if you watch this, I apologise. Or Ratchet 5. Anyway. This bit here blimmin' annoys me. Unless you can get into that area, so look, he's going to be prepared now to push you out like that. I can never get that right. Sorry if I sound peeved, but I'm going to rant about it. It blimmin' infuriates me. See, I lost 2 health bars for that. Insomniac, why'd you do that to me? I thought we had something. He broke my heart there, that poxy jump. It's the only annoying Rhynoc in this game, seriously. It isn't half infuriating. There we go, though. Told you that getting all the fodder is always worthwhile. Whilst there's an extra life out of it. Can't complain there. Now the fun really begins. Now we literally are hopping to Rapunzel, as it were. It's a shame she has no hair to let down that we can sort of grab onto. Although if Spyro was here doing that bit, he'd probably flame the hair and it would all burn up or something. Which would be very comedic, actually. I'd like to see that. It'd be interesting seeing, the other characters in the game attempting the other characters' missions, as it were. Sparks is good, though. He goes with all of them. He never gets a minute off. He's always on set, in front of the camera, as it were. This should be the last jump now. I think this is all the... Hopefully I've got enough gems. Up we go. And there she is. Does have enough gems. Need 900, don't we? Oh, for flip's sake.
What? Marco sent you here? I've got a restraining order against
you. She's only pink there in the entire game. Every other guy looks like the same, and she's distinctly pink, as it were. And that dragon's behaving like a dog. How interesting.
If you see Marco, please tell him I've moved
on. Okay, well, I'll stop recording now and try and find the other gem. Yeah, I found it. If you're a rugby fan feeling discontented at the Six Nations at the moment, be happy at least that I found all the gems. It's all good. That's level done. Hope you've enjoyed my level guide of Sunny Villa. That's quite a nice little cutscene now here, but I'll let you watch that without any commentary. I'll see you in the next part for Cloudy Spires. See you then.
Ooh, look out, Hunter. It's the scary sorceress.
I've warned you already. This place isn't safe for small dragons and pussycats.
Thanks, but I think we can look after ourselves.
Try looking after this!
Come back when you finish witch school, okay?
Say, is it just me, or is she kind of cute when she's angry?